Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel, and welcome to part one of a new series I'm doing called Ram King Retrospective. So for those of you who don't know, I play the character Ram on a Thai BL series called My Engineer. So my character Ram is a couple with the character King. Well, technically they're not actually a couple yet. So in Ram King Retrospective, I'm going to be watching all of the Ram King scenes from My Engineer. I'm going to talk a little bit about my acting, what I think of the scene, maybe in terms of the whole story. And I'll also be sharing some behind the scenes stories. So if there's anything funny that pops into my head about when we were shooting a particular scene, I'll be sharing those too. So before we get started, please don't forget to press like, because that lets me know you like it, lets YouTube know you like it. And also don't forget to press subscribe and comment down below if you really like this video, if there's anything you want to share about what you thought about a particular scene, or maybe if there's anything else you'd like me to react to in the future. Okay, so let's get started with Ram and King's first scene together in episode 3. It's funny how all of us look so different in the series. I mean, a little bit of time has passed since it was on, over a year, but it's funny how like people look a bit different now. By people, obviously, I mean me, intellect. Okay, so obviously in that first scene, there's not really much going on. So obviously King's personality, he's a very curious person in general. That he's literally just interested in, like, who is this guy with this tattoo? He just looks really interesting to King. And then obviously at this point in time, I feel like Ram, he just wants to read his cute little doggy book in peace. He doesn't want people looking at him. And I feel like that's not really as much of a character trait as it is just people in regular life. Like, how would you feel if you were at a library and you were just standing there reading a book? And then you look over your shoulder, someone's just like, nice hair. I'll talk about it after. It was kind of cool having that hair because I don't usually have my hair up in regular life, so having my hair up all the time for shooting was pretty fun. But some angles, that hairstyle looks a bit funky. This scene always makes me laugh.
What's your name? Are you from?
Bonjour.
Bonjour. Konnichiwa.
That was a really nice dog. I'm pretty sure his name was Charcoal. He was a really, really nice dog. I like Labradors. So he can tell that I'm a first year from the clothes I'm wearing. So I think in real life, especially if someone came to talk to you and you knew that they were like a second year or a senior student compared to you, you wouldn't just ignore them like that. But Ram, he's a little bit different. And it's not that at this point in time, he doesn't actually have any dislike for anyone around him. He doesn't dislike King. But he just has literally 0% interest. And like, also, as you can see in that scene, like, Ram has a little bit of a sassy side. For example, King keeps asking him what languages he can speak. And then he says to the doggy, "Khoi khoi kin," which means like, take your time eating, eat slowly. To let King know that, yeah, he can speak Thai. And also that he understands everything that he's saying. So it was really funny in that scene. It was really hard to get the dog to stay in one position. So I had to kind of like hold the dog, but then the dog would keep covering me up on the camera, so it would like stand in front of me. And then also when I walk off, the dog is supposed to stay there, but the dog would keep walking off. But then we got that good shot where it was standing there drinking the water, so it all worked out in the end. But I think that's going to be a recurring theme throughout this, is that working with animals always isn't the easiest thing. Even though they can do it when practicing, when it comes to shooting. I don't know, maybe the dogs are getting a bit camera shy. Oh, the doggies.
Oh, Vila, welcome all home.
What's up, bro? Flashbacks. Like, Ram at this point, I don't think he has any feelings of affection to that extent, but he just feels like that guy was actually kind of funny. So I feel like at that point in time, it's maybe jumped up to, let's just say 5 or 8%. About 8%, let's just say it's gone up to about 8%. Oh, and then also, my little brother in the show, if you guys didn't realize already, he actually has psychic powers. He can read his big brother's mind, so he knows everything that's going on. He's either a psychic or a detective, or a psychic detective. It's so funny. So Ram gets caught smiling. He's like, what are you smiling about? He's like quite a private person in general. This just reminded me of that funny video of Kanye West smiling, and then he realizes that the camera is catching him smiling, so then he just goes... He literally knows everything. I love these characters. So he's played by a guy called Safe. He's a super, super funny guy. He's really, really good at acting. That's funny, I like that one. Oh, here he is. Now he wants to stick around. So I just want to say that, like, in general, like, Ram's a very focused person. So I remember when we were doing workshops, there's a common exercise that we do where you have like a point of focus and you walk to it as the character, and you walk to it and then you pick a new point and you walk to it again. Ram is the type of person, when he has a focus or a goal, he just walks straight until he gets to the goal. He doesn't stop. He doesn't like get halfway or like get distracted by other things. I mean, obviously he sees Kings there, but he's listening to Piti speak. So that's where his attention is 100% focused. And also, if we go by the meter that I made before, it's still at around like 8%. So I don't think it's enough to pull his attention away from something else at this point in time.
ชื่อแปลกนี่นั่นแน่
Yeah, so obviously, as I was saying before, so King, he really likes things that are weird or interesting to him. And I think that at this point in time, especially he's saying that Ram is like someone who's hard to get to know. It's hard to get close to him. I think it makes King want to get to know him even more. Like he sees it as a bit of a challenge, not in a bad way, not like, oh, I'm going to get close to this guy and then leave. But he just wants to see exactly what's all about this mysterious guy. Nice house. Oh, this scene's really cute. This is an Aram scene, but it's still really cute, so let's leave it in.
Hey, what do you want? Bring on,
It's really interesting. I never really thought about it, how he's kind of comparing Ram to a plant. Because he loves plants. Nah, but there's not. Oh, I like this scene. Oh, this is important because this is one of the few times you actually get to see him smile on the TV show. So you saw that little smile just then. It's because he's talking to someone that he actually loves, like one of his best friends. So in the show, Ram only has literally like four friends at the beginning anyway. Like he's not emotionless all the time. Very occasionally, if it's his friends or family, he'll do a little smile. One of the things that makes Ram's character is how much he loves his friends and how much he wants to protect and support his friends. So it's a little important. Here we go. So at this point in time, even though something kind of funny happened the other day, when King walks in and he's like, hey, Ram's reaction to this is like, oh, this guy again. It was just something funny that happened and he just wants to move on and go back to his regular life. So Ram has goals, or he has things that he wants to do specifically. So when the scene started, he's waiting for Dylan to come to give him the box to get the donations. Then he's going off to take the box to get donations. King says, I'll give you some. As soon as King donates, he's like, all right, my work here is done. And he literally tries to get out of there. And then, well, we'll see what happens. That's right. And we're out again. When me and Talay shoot scenes together, I tend to laugh a lot. I remember laughing a lot at that scene. When he pulls out the 500 baht note, which is the second largest banknote in Thailand, we were kind of discussing what's the best way to make it go in the box. So one thing that we experimented with at the beginning was for me to just accidentally tap his hand, to be like, oops, like tap his hand, and then he would drop it in by accident. But that felt a little bit too natural, because at that point my hands are under the box, so there was no opportunity for me to kind of like get my hand up and knock his hand, if you know what I mean. Or like, there was another thing that we tried where I moved forward and bumped the box into him to make him drop it in. We couldn't really get that accidental kind of effect, so we just decided on me literally just going whoop and dropping it in the box, which is also kind of funny because, like I was saying before, I like that kind of sassy side that he has. And once he sees kind of King's hesitation to put this money in, because it is quite a lot of money, it's probably around 500 baht, it's like $20 US, $18 US, something like that, he's like, I'm gonna take this. Guys, don't forget to make sure you're drinking enough water every day. That wave's so funny. At this point in time, it's the same kind of feelings he has before. He's like, this guy again. And then obviously King thinks that Ram's gonna respond to his messages, but actually someone's just calling.
ขอบใจกลับไปหาพ่อแม่บ้างนะพวกเขาคิดถึงรู้แล้ว
Dude, there's a strand of hair like going like this on my face, and it's really annoying me at the moment. But that being said, at this point they've probably been working on all the cam stuff for a long time.
ทักมารู้ไม่กล้าตอบต่อหน้าน้องเดี๋ยวถ้าให้เดานะคนที่ทักมาคือคนที่พี่เจอพร้อมกับหมาเขาคงไม่เห็นผลอะไรสักอย่างถึงได้ติดต่อมาในเรื่องจริงๆอ่ะพี่ไม่ได้เกลียดเขาไม่งั้นพี่บล็อกไปนานแล้วใครนะทำให้พี่เราเขินได้ขนาดนี้
There's actually another reason why the little brother says all those things is because Ram is such a silent character. What he's saying is literally what Ram's thinking, so that's why he goes into so much detail and knows everything that he says, is because it's just a device to explain what's happening inside Ram's head at that time. I like this spot. This spot looks really nice. So, you can see from his reaction there, Ram is actually already getting frustrated because he doesn't understand some of the engineering questions. So, like, when King comes over his shoulder and is like, huh, I'm actually getting a lot of those wrong. He's like, first of all, he doesn't know who it is, and it doesn't matter who it is. I feel like Ram would get annoyed. Oh, and look, there's a few strands of hair dropping down. Nice.
อันนี้ทําอะไรเนี่ยงานจ๋าวิชัยเหรอกูสอนเหรอป่ะอะไรแม่กูสอนเหรอไม่ต้องอายเอาดิไว้ให้มันขาดเนี่ยแล้วไม่มีส่งจานเนี่ยแค่เนี้ย
I remember when we were shooting this scene, when we like pulling the piece of paper, we accidentally ripped a cup. I think both of us were holding on to it a little bit too hard, and we actually ended up ripping like parts of the paper off.
Hey, Rudy.
Also, this scene here, it inspired a lot of really nice fan art. sorry about that. I had some technical difficulties. My camera battery ran out, so I had to charge it up. And in the time it took me to charge up, the sun went down, so the lighting's going to be a bit different, but let's carry on. I didn't study engineering, so I know nothing about engineering. And also Talay, he's said to me that he's not particularly good at maths. So when we were doing this scene, I think he was saying something along the lines of, just put X over Y, divide it by 3, multiply it by 10, like that kind of math stuff. And then meanwhile, I was just going, Okay. Why use words when you can use actions? Doggie! So Ram is looking at King and trying to let him know that it's okay, I'll keep you safe. You don't need to worry about the dog. So to be able to express that through my eyes, one thing that I used was an inner monologue. So while I'm looking at him, I'm literally saying in my head, don't worry about the dog, I'm good with dogs. Just stick with me and you'll be fine, that kind of thing. So as I say it in my head, with enough feeling, then it should be able to be read through my eyes. So it makes King, the character, also feel at ease. Sounds funny. I don't think that Ram dislikes the girl. He just feels literally zero towards this person. So he's just like, someone's like, oh, can I have your number? He just goes, And that's like a little important thing there as well. So in case you missed it, so King taps Ram on the arm there. So Ram doesn't feel like, ew, don't touch me, because I remember when I was shooting this scene, I accidentally acted like that. So when King taps Ram on the arm like this, I accidentally went like, and then the like assistant director came in and said, no, you don't like feel disgusted or angry. It's just kind of a foreign feeling, because he's only usually close with his friends. So someone who is not his friend yet taps him on the arm, he's kind of like, this is new. Oh, this is funny, I like this bit. He loves his mommy.
มึงไปซื้อตอนไหนเนี่ย ให้กูเหรอ
It was funny, like in that particular scene, I wanted to go for more of a wet look, like to be totally drenched. I thought it would be funnier for it to be that way. But I don't think my engineer is like that much 100% slapstick comedy, so just had a little spray down. Ram messaging and being proactive from his side shows that he feels a little bit closer to King, and also he obviously feels really grateful for teaching him the homework, which is a really important step in their relationship. So I think we can take that from about 8% and maybe move it up to around
15%.
Ram really doesn't like that. Oh, his face is so funny here. I love this
part.
Now this is really funny because I remember shooting this scene. So King is talking about the levels of loneliness that people experience. So like level 15 is this, level whatever is that, level whatever is this. And so in Ram's head, as King is reading this out, he's going like, wait a minute, I do that. He says the next one and then Ram is like, wait, I do that as well. Ram himself doesn't think of himself as a lonely person or someone who is that particularly solitary. He's just him, so he doesn't know anything different. So it's really funny, like his self-realization at each point that King says.
Level 15 is การพูด คน เดียว. But level 35 is การ เดิน ห้าง คน เดียว. แล้ว ขึ้น มา เป็น level 50 คือ การ ดู หนัง คน เดียว. แต่ มึง ไง นิ่ง.
At that point, he's like, but I just went to see a movie by myself last week.
น่าจะระดับประมาณ 75 มั้ง.กินข้าวคนเดียวเนี่ยมึงคงไม่ถึงระดับร้อยหรอกปะชีบเรือเป็ดคนเดียวอ่ะ อ่ะเอาไปกินเว้ยรุ่นน้องนะเว้ยเกรงใจกว่า
This is funny. There's a funny story behind
กินให้หมดกินเข้าไปดิแดก
แดก
แค่เนี้ย
ความจริงผมไม่ชอบกินขิงแต่ผมยอมกินเพราะพี่คิงตักให้
That's also okay. So there's two funny stories. So there's like a recurring thing. So when Ram says something kind of nice to King, and then King looks back at him like, huh? Then Ram just immediately shifts his eyes away and just goes. So that happens maybe two or three times in the series. And this, there's also another really funny thing about this scene. So what happens is King puts some ginger in Ram's food, but Ram doesn't like eating ginger. So when we're shooting this scene, I have to eat it so to make it look like I don't like it. So I remember when we were shooting this scene, the director came over and he comes up to me and he says, Perth, are there any foods like you don't like to gin? You don't like to gin? Sorry, I mixed up Thai and English. Sorry. He comes up to me and he says, are there any food you don't like to eat? Because he says sometimes it's a little bit difficult to act, to pretend to eat things you don't like that you actually like. So he goes, is there anything that you don't like so we can just pretend that it's that instead? And I was like, actually, I really don't like ginger. And he was like, oh, right, good. Well, let's just eat the ginger in the scene. And I was like, no problem. Leave it to me. It's kind of hard to see because of the camera angle, but that's actually my face when I eat things I don't like, which is in this case, ginger. Okay, that's the end of part one of Ram King Retrospective. I really enjoyed shooting this video because I have obviously a lot of memories from my time shooting My Engineer Season 1, and I never know what's going to pop up into my mind or little details that come back to me, or even stuff that I figure out after watching it back for maybe the third or fourth time, maybe fifth time. So if you guys enjoyed it, please let me know in the comment section below, and I'll see you guys in the next video. See ya!